Tonight's episode is brought to you in part by Jenna Club TV and Wilson's Pizza and Grill.
It's from my pops, California coastlines, living out my real mind. Now it's really showtime, now it's how I draw a line. From the fake to real, that's how it feels when you multi. But let's not forget all of the giants I want to stunt down. Scared that their positions can't be taken with a new sound.
Got a nigga, I'm not your feelings, bitch. And I'm gonna eat it like a a Douglas thing, y'all. Come check me out. It's William Douglas with Douglas Lemonade. We're on the Next Evening Social podcast coming up next. Check me out.
What's happening, good people? I have to have you here tonight on the Evening Social podcast. It's happy. Appreciate everyone for coming. We got something special tonight, all right? And we're going to do things a little different. You probably saying, Coach, you said that the last 2-3 episodes. Right. We doing something different. But each time, it's something different from the different from the different. Okay?
Right,
something different. I had to switch it up because my man come through. You know what I'm saying? And it's a Douglas thing.
You know.
You're going to figure that out.
Let's get all right? it.
Now, I am first things first. Don't forget the Coach. Then comes Mo.
And I'm Jabril Janae.
And you are here at 1739 Gallery, the home of the Evening Social podcast.
Yeah.
Now, we cannot forget our DJ, the baddest DJ in the land.
Yeah. Say
it. DJ Rich.
Say it again.
The baddest DJ in the land.
Yeah, okay.
You listen, I'm going to say this. They hate when I say
yo,
it.
Say
my
it.
DJ better than your DJ.
No DJ.
Better than
no
your DJ.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Now, some of y'all don't understand why I'm saying this. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to just hit y'all with this real quick. You know, we've been doing this for over a year and a half. You know, we got 70 episodes tonight. You know, 70 Let's episodes.
Let's go.
And DJ Ben Rich, the only person, got his own camera. You know what I'm saying? He got his own camera. None of us got our own camera. You know what I'm saying? But he does. So
we renegotiating contracts.
Listen,
2023.
You know, that's what Jabril been saying. We got to renegotiate these things. Okay,
listen.
There we go.
Yeah.
All right. So I got to get something out the way real quick. First, I want to just pay a little bit of homage to our partnerships that we have for us. Our episode partner is brought to you in part by Wilson's Pizza and Grill.
Yeah.
Also, it's brought to you in part by Henderson Entertainment. They taking KC artists to the worldwide platform.
Shout out to Tom.
Yeah. Also, New Wall Street, an investment education community. All right. And Jenna Club TV, now on Roku.
Now on Roku.
Let's
say
yeah.
that.
Now on Roku.
All right,
say it. Now on Roku.
You had to put it on the night.
I put
night
on the night.
Yeah,
night
yeah,
tone,
I hear you. The after dark.
After dark. Yeah, there we go. All right. Now, we also, I got to put this out here. We also have some brand partnerships. And we have one of our brand partnerships in the house tonight, Miss Kamisha, with the lovely Brainiac 91.
Come you on, Brainiac.
Comfort with a little bit of style. Get into it. Go ahead, do your thing. T, get a picture of her, man, because she be hating and saying, let's look at the picture.
The Wanda Lee.
Get a picture. This the Wanda Lee? Yeah, get a picture of the Wanda Lee. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you get a picture, Kamisha back there and her thing. She in there. We appreciate her being out here tonight. You know what I'm saying? Thank you. And then you see.
T-Money.
He got his own camera. He don't get no extra pictures.
Woo!
You know what I'm saying? Now, also, I got to go ahead and say to a brand partnership, we got Truth Apparel. You know what I'm saying? Truthapparel.com. Make sure you get that. You know what I'm saying? You there? There.
Oh, I thought you had something smart to say today.
I'm just looking. She always got, she always come for me on the couch.
You
know what I'm saying? Truthareason.com. Truth Apparel. Make sure you go there and shop. You know what I mean?
I'm not going to keep you
there. They always with us tonight. I just, because of the what we was doing, I represented another brand tonight. because we had Douglas out here today.
For sure.
I'm feeling a little cocky.
Hey, say it with your chest.
That's
I'm feeling a little cocky.
Let's go.
You know
Let's go.
I see you.
I'm on my cocky tonight. I had to say I'm just with that.
That's
now,
I'm going to
just
out.
Put it out there tonight, as we introducing who we got, first of all, my man from KC.
For sure.
He's an entrepreneur.
For sure.
Yeah.
He is a owner.
Facts.
For sure. He is a producer, not a consumer.
Say it again.
You see what I'm saying? That's something that we teach. That's going on. I'm going to say it one more time to get out here. He is a producer, not a consumer. That's something that we teaching, you know what I'm saying, every day to our youth. The other thing is, I got to say this to everybody that's here. They've been, you know, can see it. He is also a sponsor of tonight's drinks, you know, with this nice Douglas lemonade. Now, I'm going to say this. I'm going to keep it real with you before I put your hair. I'm going to put this out here. And I ain't going to lie to you.
Yes, sir.
I'm just, I ain't going to lie to you.
Let's go.
Okay. So I'm going to put this, be 100. On this show, we 100.
For sure.
Okay.
Got to.
I was a little skeptical.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie. I was a little skeptical.
I'm not mad.
I was a little skeptical. Yeah. All right. And because we got a lemonade in Kansas, in Wyandotte, Nelson's Lemonade.
Okay.
And they fight.
Okay.
I'm talking about fire. Yeah, people fire. Line up. I'm talking about 2 hour lines.
For sure. For sure.
And, you know, and they got flavors. And so I was skeptical. You know, because, you know, one thing you said, you can try the rest, now try the best.
You I heard right. That,
you know. Right. And so I was like,
okay. Really not want to be there.
Ain't right. He talking a little too much stuff, huh?
So I'm like, okay. So I was like, let me try this. Let me see this. So I hit the first one. What's that?
Had to double back twice.
Let me try this again. Make sure, because this could be, you know, my palate ain't clean. You know, let me check this out again.
No.
Right. So I went back. I'm like, I don't feel it in here.
Nah, not at all.
It had a good taste. It was.
Man, you can tell it's fresh too.
It's fresh. Had a good taste.
Hey, listen.
Get you nice know. And cold.
So now I'm gonna say this. I put it up there with Nelson's. You know, it's
I
up there.
I see you do it.
For
you
sure.
Know what I'm saying?
I heard
so you. I'm gonna say we got Mr. Douglas. It's a Douglas thing, y'all, on the couch.
Mr. Douglas himself.
Okay, Mr. Douglas over everything. Douglas Lemonade. William Douglas here with us tonight.
For sure, for sure. Y'all better come check us out. Everybody tune in. Y'all know what it is. Mm. It's the best lemonade out there. Fresh lemons, puree, strawberries. We getting it in. I'm doing everything from scratch. We're going to get it in on this show. All honesty. Let's get it.
Man, let's go. And tonight, if you're not in the house, you can't partake. But guess what? You know, Douglas Lemonade took over the bar.
Yeah, we did.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
took over the bar, so you can take Douglas Lemonade with any of the flavors of, you know, the center bar and all that. But you're not here, you can't catch that out.
Hey.
But I'm telling you, get down here because it's still limited access.
Yeah.
Limited access. Let's go.
Man, y'all low-key be sleeping.
They got their cup
our
right
audience
there.
Members always be getting the hookup.
Yeah, I ain't, you know, they ain't here for that. Now, William, they don't want to ask you this. I got to ask. They always make me ask the hard questions.
Who is they?
You know, well, okay, I'm not. We said honesty?
Honesty.
Okay, let's Jabril always make me ask the hard questions. So I'm going to go ahead and put that.
Let's get it.
All right. So, you know, they want me to ask you, are you married?
No, I'm not.
Okay. Do you have kids?
Yes, I do. I have seven boys.
You have seven boys.
I have seven boys.
Okay. What's the oldest and the youngest?
My oldest is 21, and then I got twin boys that's eight. Well, actually, no, I'm sorry. They just turned nine.
You just turned nine. Twin boys, so oldest 21. Now you didn't want to ask. You didn't want to ask. Now you want to jump in. But she didn't want to ask. That's just like a Washington girl. I didn't want to be the one to throw you under the bus. Oh, no, you ain't throwing me under the bus. Let's get it.
Listen, this is what I do. I got seven kings. I got seven kings. They all Douglases. So that's where that Douglas lemonade come from.
Okay.
I gotta build some generational wealth. That name gotta carry on forever.
I love it.
Are they all invested in it?
I love it.
They love it. They know
it's a whole board. My mom, my sister.
A Douglas.
It's a Douglas thing. That's what I strive myself on. It's a Douglas thing.
She didn't hear me say it's a Douglas thing on the couch.
Yeah.
Then she didn't hear Douglas
over everything.
Check his chain out. It's D-O-E.
Douglas over
everything. You got to explain for the people.
For sure. It's definitely Douglas over everything.
We was going to get to that, but I see he need to explain.
You know, a lot of people's last name mean a lot to him.
What you got, the laptop?
So now since you coming for me, let me explain to you. The people said, my kids told me, they said, Coach, you gotta move up.
Now he on the phone.
They told me, Coach, you gotta move up. You got that old. You got that old analog. I said analog. I didn't even know. They said that's what it looked like. You got that old big screen up there. Yeah, you need to get to. I said okay. So now I upgraded. And T Money even smiling now. But T Money was a little embarrassed to be out with me. You know what I'm saying? Now he like cool. He like, Coach, I ride with you now. You know, I'm upgraded. We got that I fixing.
For sure.
Okay,
for sure.
There
you
we
got
go.
To. Now, you gotta get the green, not the blue. I mean, you gotta do the blue, not the green. You gotta have blue, not the green.
Blue, not the green?
Yeah, you want the blue messages, not the green messages.
There you go. Okay, there we go. I know what that means.
Say ketchup mustard.
Say ketchup mustard.
No, I know what that means. See how you, boy, you always. No. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Come on, man.
No, we not. Hold on. Let me do this. No. For anybody that don't know, I've been confined to this part of the couch since we started. You know, now I understand why she been letting me get a little closer so she can shoot me down. If I'm going to just stay over here on my side. No, don't. Stay on your side. I'm staying on my side. All right. Okay. So, William, we got a couple things that we're going to do today. One of our first segments that we're going to get into is one of my favorite segments. It's called Fun Questions. It's the icebreaker. It's brought to you by, you know what I'm saying, Drip Ultra Pure Watch.
Okay.
My guy David Jordan.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
Know
I know.
Saying? Yeah,
I know.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
The homie.
Yeah. So we're going to get
brother.
Into that.
That's a,
yeah.
That's a good brother.
Yeah, good brother. Real good brother. So we brought to you by Drip Ultra Pure Water. You're not knocking the walls
okay,
down.
Okay, come on, bro.
Okay. All right, we're going to let you go first.
You going to let me go first?
Yeah, we're going to let you go first.
All right. Drip, drip. Thought I didn't catch that. Okay, first question. Is it legal for a man to marry his widow's sister?
What state? This state?
Any state. Pick one.
No.
No. Is it legal?
Good job. Why?
Good old sister. I
don't know. Come on.
I thought you was going to get it because you
come on. Hold now. Slow down. So I'm going to do what she do. I'm going to do what she do
right,
now.
Right.
I'm giving lifeline. Slow down. That's
read,
what they be doing. She
the
going to be
read the question again.
Is it
there,
legal?
Okay, there we go.
That was good. I'm going to give it to him. Is it legal for a man to marry his widow's sister?
His widow's sister.
You don't get no help from the you know, audience. You don't have lifelines out there.
His widow's sister.
His mm-hmm. widow's sister.
So his widow. Yeah, because he did.
There we go. Okay, moment. All right, put one on there.
Oh,
yeah.
Hey,
yeah. Listen, now I'm telling the audience they can't say nothing, but you can't glance over there because your man helped you. I mean, you can look over. I mean, at least look once or twice.
Hey, I had to think about it. You know what I'm saying? Slow it down. All
right. All right. Now, this one here, think about it. Think about it.
Think about it.
And think about it.
Think about it.
Let's go.
All right. Now, what two words hold the most letters when combined?
Hold the most?
I said, let me think see. About it, think about
so
it,
let me
think
see.
About it. And
let
he's
me
just
see.
Gonna spout nah. out something.
I'm talking still.
Okay.
Let me see. All right.
So
read the question.
What two words hold the most letters when combined? Now I'm just asked another question. This is just a per question. So, what high school you graduate from?
Grandview High School.
Okay, so I got it now. Go ahead. Okay. So, what two words hold the most letters when combined?
What two words?
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah.
What two words?
Wait,
well,
let me see.
You don't even know the answer.
I know the answer.
Cause you read it.
No, I knew the answer. I knew the answer before that.
Man, you
see,
I'm trying to be
listen,
here for you.
This is, hold on. So let me give you the history of this. She always try to cheat and see my questions and stuff. You see what I'm saying?
We I don't know why we can't
out.
Just stick together. She you always want to air.
I mean, you threw me on the bus when we started.
Read
so,
that question
you know,
one more time. What two words
we,
hold
we,
the most?
Yes.
We enemies now. I mean, most. I love you, sis.
I know.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know that.
Okay, T-Money, make sure you get a picture of the stump, because this is going on our stump wall.
This is him stumped.
This is a stump wall. This is going on our stump wall. Now, we do have a stump wall. You have just made the stump wall.
All right.
Okay.
What was the answer?
The two words that hold the most letters when combined is post office.
That's childish, man. All right. Look at him.
I'm just saying, man.
He can't even miss it.
I'm just saying. You know, listen to me. I understand. With your grandview. It's okay. You know.
We had some good people come out of Grandview.
That's some great people. Alex Burke, I mean, some great people. You know, but he came out for basketball.
Yeah. What's the boy came out for football?
Yeah, they came out for football.
This is academic.
This is academic. Hey, Ben, he might need to help you since you come from Sumner and KCK. He might need a lifeline with you. We'll put that out there. Now I'm just talking. This all joke.
Oh yeah.
All right, man. I got my next question.
I just had to make sure I put out there. Yeah. I just talk stuff and joke. Yeah. It's just all the fun. Ain't no.
Gotta get it in. Okay.
I just want to put that out there. You know, because I am in Missouri. I don't want to walk outside. You know, talking about what. You know what I'm saying? William, I'm just talking. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to get down. You know what?
We good on both sides. We good.
I tell Wap, go ahead and lean now. Lean now. Let's get back here. You know what I'm saying? All the way.
What you got for me?
Okay. What goes up and down but always remains in the same space or the same place? What'd you say?
Air.
Listen, I would take it, but that ain't it wrong. No, it's stairs.
You're right.
That's a good one.
Goes up, comes down, stays in the same place.
What about elevators?
No, because it leaves.
It moves.
It leaves.
The stairs stays in one spot, and you walk up and down.
It's the same space.
I get it.
Smart.
This is true.
How many more questions you got?
I think that's one more.
I'm gonna just say this. So you are what? One and two.
Yeah, one and two.
Okay,
we're
gonna have to up this, you know, because I can't.
But air was kind of two though.
I mean, hair could. Can hair? Listen, you know, I would have gave it to you. For sure. I would have.
I'm gonna give you this one. So I know we should be two and two after this.
Let's go.
Okay.
Let's go.
So how many animals did Moses take into the ark?
Two of each.
You said, hold on. Moses,
he didn't take none.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. My man. Okay. Now I'm not gonna say
Noah,
nothing.
Noah was the boy.
Okay, there we go. Noah. Okay, that's what I'm saying.
Noah built the ark.
The boy took the ark.
We want to stay in the mic so we can hear you, but I ain't gonna
Noah
say.
Noah was the one that took the ark.
There we go. I ain't gonna say nothing about how they was jumping up over there. Like, well, we good. Okay, there we go. Last question from her and me. We got one more.
Okay, I'm doing one more.
I thought we was leaving off on two and two. I could have gave you a different one. You could have been one and three.
Nah, we good.
Okay, we two good. And two. Come on, two and two.
I'll take what I get.
Okay, there we go. This one, I just want people who know.
This
let me just
one.
Say that, hold on. People who know, this next one come from Bob the Bum.
Oh, my God.
People who know about that, if you ain't been following, you know. Bob the Bum, if you don't answer his question, he get $5 to eat. So he come up with them stompers. Yeah, so I'm just letting you know. That's what's coming up after hers.
Mine is, how many seconds are there in a year?
How many seconds are there in a year?
I
seconds is in a year.
Ben, can you hit us with that music? You know. Can you hit us with that music, please? So you know what music it is. I don't got to say nothing. We going to give him his time.
It's a trick question.
Go ahead, ask him one more time. Ask him one more time.
How many seconds are there in a year?
Okay.
It's 12.
How many seconds is in a year?
January 2nd, February 2nd.
Woo! So now we at 2 and 3. Here's the last one. Let's go.
Crack yourself up.
Right.
Go ahead, okay.
Hey, listen, I do not want y'all to talk about Bob the Bum. He's trying to eat. Bob the Bum trying to eat. Bob the Bum got another $5. You can't say now Bob the Bum got $5. You know what I'm saying? He on the curb trying to eat.
He can get a drink.
Ah, man, now you want to thumb down Bob the Bum.
He gets a Douglas lemonade.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure he'd like that. I'm sure he'd like a little Douglas lemonade to wash down, you know, this burger that he about to get.
$5 box.
Yeah. You know, Bob, listen to him. I'm just saying this for ask the question. The last meal, you know, Bob was able to go, you know, 2 for $20 last meal. You know what I'm
really
saying? Last time Bob went on 2 for $20. He can't get that on you.
Good.
I'm just saying Bob went on 2 for $20 the last meal. Okay. All right, now this one here. I just, now think about it, because this was Bob the Bum's double, you know, star question for the day.
All right. Oh, my God.
If you threw a red rock into a green sea, what would it come back as?
A red rock. A rock.
If you threw a red rock into a green sea, what would it come back as? And your answer is what?
You said a green rock into a red sea?
No, I didn't say that.
What color rock?
So you want me to read again?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll read again. Yeah. Now, so T-Money, make sure that we get all this started, because this is definitely going to be the teaser for... This is definitely going to be the teaser when we put this out for this episode. Okay? And so I said this. If you threw a red rock into a green sea, what would it come back as?
A red rock.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Well, if you threw a red rock into a green sea, it would come back as wet.
You're so childish, bro.
Wet, because it went into the water. It comes back wet.
You know, is water wet?
Huh?
Is water wet?
Is water? So now you want to ask the question?
Yeah, is water wet?
No, you don't ask questions. We ask questions. You know, you answer questions. We ask the questions. You know, I'm just saying. We ask the questions. You answer the questions. We ain't interviewing you. That's all I'm saying. Okay, that's it. Don't try to ask me. Don't try to start asking me questions. See if he can stump me. Now he wants to stump me. He wants to get me on the bloopers. No, sir. You won't have me on the bloopers. T, he tried me, didn't he?
I tried.
T, he tried. It's okay. Hey, checking ain't cheap.
Hey.
Checking ain't cheap. Checking ain't cheap. All right. So before we get to this break, real quick, I got to ask a couple quick questions. And then we're going to get to a break, and then we're going to come back and get more into something. We just wanted to have a little fun, kind of break it down,
and
do all that. So where were you born?
Kansas City, Missouri.
Kansas City, Missouri.
Yes, sir.
All right, so you in 30s, 40s, 50s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 110s?
56 and Askew is where I was raised.
So you off of Askew, 56 and
Askew. Dead End Street.
Dead End Street. Yep. You already said you graduated from Grandview.
Yep, graduated from Grandview.
So what middle school and grade school you go to?
So middle school, I ended up moving to Arizona. So we moved to Arizona when I was young. So my first and second grade, I was in Arizona.
Okay.
When we moved back, I ended up going to Ingalls, out south.
Okay.
And then from Ingalls, I went to Smith Hill.
Okay.
From Smith Hill, I ended up going to Lee Summit. From Lee Summit, then I went to Grandview, graduated from Grandview.
Graduated from Grandview.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Nice. So now I'm just going to ask some questions. I'm going to tell you why. Because this interview is not just for the community, but it's also for some of our youth, our kids, our students.
Yeah.
So we need to humanize, because sometimes kids see, oh, you a business owner, you, and they never think that you was a kid or had anything else, you know what I'm saying? But you come through things.
Yeah.
So talk to us about growing up. Can you talk to us about your relationship with your parents? Let's start with the relationship with your father.
Father, he wasn't there. That wasn't a relationship that was ever built. Him and my mom split when I was young. So growing up in my adolescence, I really didn't know my father. Mother was, strong, black, female, single mother, raising two kids. I got a sister, older sister. And she installed a lot into us. That's who helped me become the man I am.
Okay.
Is my mother. So I stand behind her a lot. Now, as we get deeper into the interview, me and my father ended up getting together. The pain I had in my heart because my father wasn't there, I ended up being able to rekindle that and learn who I am as a man from my father. You know what I'm saying? So it helped me become a man. So one thing I want to say is any young black male that's father's that's not there or trying to be around, definitely know where you come from. Definitely know where you come from. If you have a black male father that's in your life or trying to be in your life, definitely take that in and at least try to build some type of relationship, because you don't want to grow up having a chip on your shoulder because he wasn't there, or you're not
putting nothing on a woman,
but you just listen to your mom's side and you're not really learning where you came from, because you came from two people. You didn't come from one person.
Were you an adult when you rekindled with your father?
I was 30, how am I, 40?
So I was like
36, 37. It's recent. Recent, but it helped me grow. It helped me grow to a different level of a man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So
I like how you said that, because, we're not knocking things, but there's always two ways of looking at things, two sides of it. Not saying that one is wrong or not. It's just always two sides. People are one way viewing it, people are another way
Yeah, especially if you see one parent every day. You see one parent every day, then even in your head, the parent don't have to necessarily say anything. But in your head, you already get an idea. You know what I'm saying? And in certain situations, like you said, I'm not saying it's right or it's wrong or whatever, but as adults and humans, everybody makes mistakes. Even as a parent, as a child, That's why we live. That's why we grow, because of mistakes. If we don't make mistakes, we'll never grow. So
for sure.
I'm glad you shared it.
Yeah,
I appreciate you sharing
that.
Now I have to ask one more part about family. Two more parts.
Yeah, for sure.
One is, what about the role that say grandparents played in your life?
Grandparents were strong. Grandparents are strong. I make jokes because now it's the club grandmas. You know what I'm saying? All the grandmas is in the club.
Yeah,
they ain't baking cookies. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I grew up, my grandma was baking cookies.
My grandma was making lemonade.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that's really where I got my recipe from.
Was young, my grandma used to make lemonade. I used to always tell her, like, Grandma, I need your recipe. She died on me. So when she died on me, it was like years passed. But I always been a lemonade fan. So as I got older, something just clicked in my head. And I was like, I want to try to duplicate my grandma's recipe. This is when my father came back in my life. Mm-hmm. So now that my father's in my life, I need your taste buds, because this is your mother. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that's how I created my brand. And that's why I did Douglas, because it's Jenny Mae Douglas. You know what I'm saying? That's her name. That's my name. That's my family name.
So say that again, because I want to hear that.
Jenny
name is what?
Jenny Mae Douglas.
Jenny Mae Douglas. Yep. Okay, and that's
sound weird. Country, don't it? Jenny Mae Douglas. That's country.
But it is. You know what I'm saying? It's
sure.
Sentimental. It means something, and it's the reason why you created a name. Yeah, yeah. And I just want them, for our listeners, to understand that you just didn't come out with Douglas because of the show.
Nah,
came out with Douglas because it meant something.
That was
and what
deep.
What yeah, was behind yeah, it. We're going to touch a little
more. My grandparents, though, back to what you were saying, my grandparents played a very important role in my life. You know what I'm saying? Like, respect. I grew up. I'm an 80s baby.
Yeah.
So 82. Yeah. So I grew up with respect. Yes. No. Yeah. You know, open doors.
Yeah.
You know, I grew up like
got
that.
To.
So that came from my grandma, which my grandma installed it into my mom and my uncles. And that's what my uncles was hard.
Yeah.
My uncles was hard. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So grandparents is a strong part of a family when you got that real grandma. Like I said, when you got that grandma that's still baking cookies.
Right.
Not the one that's the 6902.
Right,
you know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right. Yeah, this is the one baking cookies and coming out.
Well, I was about to say, what is it?
You know, the 6902.
What is 6902?
I
was
playing
like
together.
She don't know what it is.
You know, you can't.
Really
you
know,
it's
you
okay.
Can.
But
y'all
I catch,
got 42 lounge.
But
here.
I catch her at Bob's
yeah,
and
yeah.
stuff. It's okay.
Bob's.
She be at Bob's and Epicurus. All that stuff. You know, he catch her over here and be like,
I
she said, Bob and Wade, Bob and Wade, Bob and Wade,
Bob
and Wade. It's all good, it's all good.
I've not been to Bob's house. I don't know who told you that.
Bob's house.
I'm
what? She, hey.
You childish, bro.
Listen.
Don't ever.
Keys, she played good. She act like she don't know, but it's okay.
I don't
it's
know.
All good.
6902.
It's all good.
Yeah.
It's
902
all good.
Over to whatever well, you want to call it.
She don't know the green
duck.
She don't know none of that
about.
Stuff. She don't know Epicurean. She don't
know
none of
that.
Oh, now you know that.
I know that.
Now you know that. Baby, you know that.
And the chicken.
And the chicken. Okay. All right, there we go.
Yeah, dude got some fire chicken.
So now let me hit this before we go on break, because once we go on break, we got to bring up, you know, my man Wizard Wop for, you know, a performance before we finish
sure.
this live. You know what I'm saying? But I got to ask you one more relationship.
Yeah, for sure.
Talk about the relationship with your siblings. Okay.
So it's just me and my sister.
Okay.
Biologically, my
right.
same mama, same father. Just uh-huh. me and my sister. We was raised growing up. It was rough. I'm a Cancer. She's a Virgo.
Are you older? Uh-huh. Come on, shout
I'm
out,
younger.
Virgo.
Hey, I'm going to tell you. Virgos and Cancers is actually, like, almost compatible type. But brothers and sister-wise,
yeah,
nah. Young, she thought she was my mama.
Mm. I mean, she older or younger?
She older.
She older, okay.
She's, like, almost 2 years.
Okay.
So she's
right.
a little under 2 years.
All right.
But she thought she was my mama.
Sisters
but
always think they're your mama.
Yeah,
so.
For sure. Listen,
yeah.
bossy.
Oh, I know.
Gotta have it their way. You know what
man.
I'm saying?
Whew.
But it's, but she
even
helped me.
Even when they
used
sister on the cap.
Nobody
oh,
bothering.
Oh, did I say that out loud? Oh, my bad. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
But sis definitely, my sister Myla, she definitely helped me. She definitely helped me, you know, become. She's a very important part of my life. You
I
know,
love that.
Growing up, I was stubborn. I wanted it my way. But sister used to always, we used to butt heads so hard because I wanted her to just be my sister. She was like, nah, I'm going to play neutral. I'm going to tell you when you're wrong.
Yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when she told me when I was wrong, as now I'm an adult and I consider myself a grown man, she helped me. She helped me know that I was wrong. I can admit when I'm wrong at something. And when
man.
I'm wrong, I got to stand up when I'm wrong. You know what I'm saying? So.
And that's so important, man. I am like. That's one of the staples of there's gonna be another staple of this conversation.
Yeah, for sure.
Because one of the things that so we have an after school program that we do with our youth and we talk and one of the things that we talk about as a staple of being able to be a successful person is accountability.
For sure.
You have to be accountable for your actions. And to be accountable is you have to admit when you're wrong.
Yeah,
you have
yeah.
to admit.
No, you have to be able to admit. Because you're never going to be right all the time.
You're not.
You're going to make mistakes.
Yes, for sure.
But to nurture good relationships and to have any type of team effort, you have to be able to admit, yo, my bad.
I
was wrong.
I always say
up.
This when we
you know?
Talk about this. Because mm-hmm. I feel like one of the most dangerous people to be around is people who are unaware of themselves.
Yeah, for sure.
People
yeah.
who are
yeah.
not willing to take criticism. People who are not willing to look themselves in the mirror. Those are the most dangerous people to be
yeah.
around.
Yeah.
I can't even.
Go back to what you just said. Look yourself in the mirror.
Yeah.
I strive hard on it. You know, I'm able to look myself in the mirror.
because I know my flaws. I know where I went wrong. I know I can admit when I'm wrong. I know what I did. I know what I didn't do. So no one can come to me and tell me anything about me. But when I look in the mirror, I could tell myself about me, and I know it.
Do you feel like that come with age?
Yeah, for sure. Young. Yeah, I look in the mirror and be like, you know what? Never mind.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Because
I
was in all types of stuff. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to sit here and say that I've just been this stand-up guy my whole life, and I never got in trouble, and I never did this, never did that.
Right.
I wouldn't be able to look myself in the mirror. Yeah. I can say that I made mistakes, so that's why I can look myself in the mirror.
Yeah. Well, that's a great thing. We appreciate you, you know, being able to say that and say that so our youth can understand
that
mistakes does not define who you are, or it doesn't make you a certain situation. Mistakes, actually, being able to be accountable and admit to your mistakes and go, that's actually what propels you to being successful. Because when you can do that, you can accept criticism.
You can, you know what I'm saying,
understand, hey, this is what I got to work on, and I got to move in here, and this is my path. Right? So, man, we appreciate
it. It ain't the mistake. It's how you come back from the mistake.
There you go. So, one of my favorite sayings, I'm glad you said that. One of my favorite sayings was a saying from Michael Jordan. I heard it a long time ago. And it was like, it ain't about having a bad night. Bounce back big.
For sure.
Bounce back big.
Yeah, count me out, because I'm going to come back harder.
Man.
I'm going to come back harder.
Man, bounce back big. And every day I'm like, okay. So I don't know if Ben remember this, but I used to always tell all my players, all my stuff, the most important play is the next play.
Forget that last play. The most important play is the next play. If I make this play the most important,
no matter what happened last play.
Yeah.
That's over. It's already happened. So looking toward the next one and making that right.
Coach Mo.
All right. So right now, we're going to get ready to take a break, a partnership break to talk about, you know what I'm saying, where we come, but.
And who's in the building, go get some Douglas lemonade and some tequila or some, what we got, Douce?
We got Douce.
Douce or some Don Julio.
Hey, we got that.
Sponsored by Douglas Lemonade.
Sponsor. Listen, I'm going to just say this. You know, stop looking at my notes and stop taking my word. Now you doing what she do. She always trying to take my lines and stuff. So now, you know, I'm going to put you out there and I'm going to tell y'all, yo, you know, it's a Douglas thing outside.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, my goodness. All right.
So let's go out there and get drinks. But do not go too fast, because it's a Wizard Wop thing here for a performance.
Yeah.
Okay, so we bringing my man Wizard Wop up here.
Wizard Wop, he dope.
Hey, listen.
He dope.
He say you like some Yeezys without the box.
Yeah, most people don't know that. He said I can't help it. You see what I'm saying?
Hey, y'all better catch up, Mustard.
That's what I'm saying.
Y'all better catch up.
All right, so we going for a break real quick. You know what I'm saying? Before we end this live, but you can catch Wizard Wop at the end of this live coming up next. All right, here we go.
Real quick before we get into this next one, shout out T Money. I see all that work that came out. Shout out DJ Ben Rich. This next one is just about rain. You know, again, there's a lot of double meanings in this. Let's see how many rain references you can catch. Let's go. Yeah. Wizard. Water that they think this is a game.
This episode was brought to you in part by Wilson's Pizza and Grill and Jenna Club TV. Our Facebook Live broadcast was brought to you in part by New Wall Street. Our musical guests are brought to you in part by Henderson Entertainment. Our live audience giveaways are brought to you in part by The Royals. Our venue partner is the Elegant 1739 Gallery. Our clothing partners are Truth the Reason and Brainiac 91. Our beverage partners are Drip Ultra Pure Water and Sweetie's Teas.
Man.
Right on set. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Man, we back after another performance from G. My man Wizard. I call him G Wizard Wop, but you know it's G Wizard the Great.
He's so
if you're on Instagram, G Wizard the Great. But it's Wizard Wop, my guy. Come back through, man. He got that smooth. Nah, he ain't in here. Okay, good. I can say this. Y'all can tell him. You know, several years ago when they first were starting rapping and, you know, doing the thing, putting songs out, you know what I'm saying? He had this song come out, and I just loved the way, like, that he talked and he put it through. And I was like, bro, you one of my favorite rappers, you know what I'm saying, coming from Kansas City. Yeah. You know
how
what I'm saying?
How long ago was this?
Man, this is like maybe 10 years ago, there was like, it's been 10 years, like it was doing oil bass and other stuff. Like, it just was his delivery, the way that he delivered, how he talked.
Yeah.
And what I loved about it is that, you know, I was around him every day.
Gotcha.
And pushing, I could hear him talk. So I'm like, I'm hearing him talk being around, but then I'm hearing him on the records. And I'm like, bro, you sound the same. Right. That's why I mess with him. Like, well, you sound the same. You're the same type of person. It was no fake. It was no new personality. It was the same person every day. You know, there was this person. Mm-hmm. So, that's what I'm talking about. He coming back. He gonna perform that at the end. Yeah, he coming back. He gonna perform that at the end. Okay. Yeah.
Man, you think you fresh?
Yeah. I had to say. Yeah. You right. He got. Oh, he back, right. So I can't say that in front of him because I don't want him to, you know. So he back now. I can't talk about it. I can't tell him, but he know it. I'm gonna see if he say. I'm gonna just see if he remembered it. I told you a long time ago. You my what? Keep it real. You forgot? Okay, he forgot. I told you my favorite rapper from here. I told you that straight up. That's why I was just telling you, man. Like, This is 10 years ago. I'm like, bro, you're my favorite rapper from here, bro.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? Because you talk and rap the same. Like, it ain't no difference from different. It was the right stuff. So, like, hey, man, give my man Wizard Wop a round of applause. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Now, William, this is a time that, you know, before we move forward, I got to put something else out there. All right. So our show, the Evening Social Podcast, is not just about, we're a platform to help springboard and push out businesses and products that are homegrown from here. And we want to push them out. You know, all these products up here are products from KC.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I'm saying? That's here, and that's what we want to push out. Now, we're not knocking products from any other states or nowhere else. You know, y'all want to come in, holler at us.
Yeah,
you know
got to.
I'm just saying, y'all want to come in, holler at us. Sis kind of mean on them contracts. I'm just, obviously. But I'm just saying, but our thing was to establish a platform for businesses, artists, you know, and entrepreneurs and people who are thriving in a professional manner. That was, you know, our means of this platform.
Sure.
But the other part was to give what we call oxygen, not flowers. We're not knocking nobody to give flowers.
Yeah, for sure.
But we give oxygen. Our meaning of oxygen is to pump life into people who are doing positive and great things and hopes to push and propel them to do more and better and let them understand that us in our community, we see you, we appreciate it, we love what you're doing. Continue to do it, my brother, and we behind you. And wish you and hope to be the greatest of everything in it. All right? So if you're here with me, please help us wish you know what I'm saying, William Oxygen for what's going on.
Get it.
Appreciate it.
All right. So as we going through here now, I got to ask a couple questions, you know, and since she can't look at my notepad, you know, she ain't got the question. I'm going to see what she had. Yeah, she ain't cheating no more. You know, I even cut my notepad off right before she could download. You know, we got it. So anyway, so one of the questions I want to get to, let's start. What prompted you? No, before I get there, I'll stop that. All right, let's go to you in Grandview High School, ready to come out. Where do you go from there? I got to go there first before we get there. Grandview High School, senior year, what are you thinking? Where are you going from there? Where does your life go?
Senior year, first son was coming.
Okay.
I'm thinking, like, I got to make a way for my son by any means necessary. Graduated, lived in Arizona when I was young. Mom's always said she was gonna move back there. A few years after I graduated, I felt like, sometimes you have to get out your city to see bigger things and really grow. And that's what I did. I moved to Arizona, stayed in Arizona for like 8 years. And really grew seeing other things, seeing other cultures. Arizona is a melting pot. It got a lot of different cultures in Arizona. So I learned a lot from Arizona, but that out of high school, that's where I went. I worked for a few years and then I moved to Arizona.
You stayed there till you was almost 30?
Yep. Came back and forth. I had kids here, so back and forth. Like I said, I was young, I was in traffic, so I was back and forth from Arizona to here. So I got tired of raising my kids from a different state. But in the midst of that, I had two kids in Arizona. So now I'm torn, you know, from Arizona and Kansas City. But I had to make a decision with my older kids to try to be more around them because they're older.
That's what prompted you to move back to Kansas City?
Yeah. But Arizona's definitely that. Arizona, I'll definitely tell any young kid, definitely get out your city and see other things, other states, other people. Don't just isolate yourself to just the Kansas City culture, because it's different cultures.
So you come back from Arizona, and now you're back in Kansas City.
I'm starting to get to the gender questions. Jenna is an Ethiopian Aramaic word.
Okay.
And part of the definition is not being afraid to speak truth to power.
For sure.
You know, that's why we chose it. The other part is a person that is not afraid, you know, to protect their community, their culture. You know, it's a culture keeper and not being afraid to protect the culture at all costs.
For sure.
You know, so sometimes I ask questions and I'm not trying to get details.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to get understanding because our youth need to see people who've made certain decisions and choices, good and bad,
right?
Or may have made certain choices and then were able to maneuver from those choices and get a different mindset to make a different choice. So now I'm going to ask you, in the era coming up, I know your age and everything coming, you know, how did the streets play into, you know, into your life and choices? And
it was major. I didn't have a father. So, you know, most males that don't have a father, what do you turn to? You turn to the streets.
Right.
My sister, like I said, she was older. So with her being 2 years older, most women, they mess with a guy a year older, 2 years older.
Yeah.
So I gravitated towards them because I didn't have no male role model. So, you know, I seen, you know, the flashy lights and the, you know, and the glitz and the glamour. So, you know, growing up, that's what you want. You know, especially when you don't have a good foundation. You know what I'm saying? When you don't have that solid foundation, when you have a strong black male, you turn to what you think looks nice. What you think looks nice. You know, everything that's glitter is not gold. You know what I'm saying? So you can't go in life just looking at
on the outside looking in. You know, a lot of young ones look at these rappers, they look at, you know, the D-boys on the block, they skirting up the street, they want to be like them, they want to be cool.
Yeah.
As you grow, you see that's not, it's not as fun as you think it is. You know, you pay for it in a lot of different ways. Tickets, you know what I'm saying? Going to jail, going to prison.
Yeah.
You go to prison, you know, you a number.
Yeah.
You victim to the streets. So, but the streets played an important part. Like I said, I'm not gonna sit here and say that I didn't make mistakes when I was mm-hmm. growing up. I made mistakes, you know. I never was real big on, you know, gang banging or robbing. Me, mm-hmm. it was more of a hustler. I knew I could sell anything.
Mm-hmm.
You know, even as I grew older and got out of that street life and really positioned myself in a legal form, mm-hmm. I say anything. Diapers, salmon,
yeah.
I say anything. And that's one thing I had to learn.
My man says salmon.
I say anything. Listen, I say people that know me out there, people that's watching this, and people that know William Douglas, aka Billy, they know. Hey, if you need something, holler at him because he gonna find it.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. That's not saying illegal.
Right.
I'm saying legal. You know anything. You know tires. You need anything. Clothes.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
I know a lot of local black designers. You know what I'm saying. So, you know, Kamisha. She got Brainiac 91. I'm wearing
Kamisha,
one now.
Brainiac
you know what I'm saying. Street Caviar. I have a lot of. It's you can sell anything, and it doesn't have to be illegal.
Right.
It doesn't.
I love that, man. Man, I love the fact, and I appreciate, you know, you being open.
For sure.
Say things, because the one thing that our youth need to understand is the fact that choices are what we all have to make.
Mm-hmm.
Choices do not define who we become. They have an effect on the consequences that we have to vote through, but they don't define who we become. And we can change our choices and move.
Sure.
And so I appreciate you, you know, being able to say that and go.
For every action, there's a reaction.
There is.
For
always.
Sure. Whether now, it's good or bad.
Man, so.
Whether it's good or bad.
There's two things I'll say. I'll say this all the time. A lot of my students, they recite this all the time. They tired of hearing me saying. I say, look, you have the opportunity to make two choices.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, yeah, good or bad? I'm like, nah, that's not the two choices.
Right, right.
And they're like, huh? I'm like, listen, you can make good or bad choices, but you have the opportunity to make a choice to either be successful or to not be successful.
Yeah, yeah.
The more good choices you make help you be successful, the more bad choices you make help you be not successful. There's not one choice that makes you successful or not. It's all the little choices.
For sure.
So you have to understand that. So you can make a choice and it may detour you, but now you can make a whole bunch of other choices to help you get on the next road.
Yeah, yeah.
So I say that all the time. The other thing that I tell them is, and I'm glad that you kind of reiterated, is, you know, you always had a choice to change, man.
For sure. For sure.
You always had a choice to change.
Yeah. Got to be your choice, though. You got to be willing to make that choice.
You always had that choice.
You got to.
It's got to be yours.
Yeah.
So I appreciate you talking about the choice to change and, you know, and being willing to say, man, I didn't make all the right choices, but I moved that way. So now I do got a couple more as we move. Okay. One of my choices is, and I'm asking this because, man, you look like a lot of our kids, and I always tell them, man, reach the people who look like you from your own backyard. So my question is, what, I hope I'm asking it the right way, what made you make the mentality, like get the mind frame, the mental thing that, this is where I want to go? You know, because you talked about a few things. So I guess it's a two-part question. Before you answer that, because you talked about, yo, I'm in Arizona. I'm doing this. I have kids here. I have kids here. I'm making this choice. You know, as you're doing this, I'm want to understand Okay. What makes you make a choice? Because there's a lot of things you could be choosing with kids, and you got several kids.
Right.
Sometimes people, let's just keep it real. Yeah, sometimes people just say it's about the money. Forget the right or the wrong thing. It's about the money. I need this money.
Right.
And that's what drives a person's mentality or drives what a person going is the value, the thinking of this is the money. But like you said, yo, everything that glitter ain't gold.
Right, right.
You
it
know,
ain't always about the money.
But they don't understand that.
Yeah, it's not always about the money.
Yeah.
You know? It's about longevity. You
yeah.
know what I'm saying? It's about
here we go. Okay.
Your name carrying weight, and not in a bad way, in a positive way. I always say, like, I want to leave an empire, but that's a positive empire. I want Douglas to be known in the community as doing positive things, but with what took me to make that decision was me and my kids.
What?
Me having seven sons. You know, me not wanting them to grow up the way I did, you know, when they don't have to.
Right.
So I want to put them in a position where they don't have to struggle the way I did, or they don't have to turn to the streets like I did. They have something to look forward to, something to look up to, you know. It's not enough black fathers that's considered superheroes. You know what I'm saying? So that's as I got older, that's just something I had to learn. I can't really put it. I can say my kids, but it was for me. I just wanted to be a better man for myself.
That's what I really want you to get to.
I had to look myself in the mirror. You know what I'm saying? And I can't look myself in the mirror and call myself a man if I'm not living right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
That's my biggest thing. My biggest thing is just, like I said, being honest, keeping it 100 with yourself, and push yourself. Don't do nothing for somebody else or because you think you're making somebody else happy. Nah, you should want to learn because you want to be smart. You don't want to be on the corner. You know what I'm saying? You want to be better. You want to be better than what your mother was, or you want to be better than what your father was. My father wasn't there, so I strive myself on being there for my kids. You know, sometimes as adults, we fall short, but I strive myself to be better than I was yesterday, and that's all I can do.
Yeah.
And that's for me. I don't care what nobody else think. As long as I can look myself in the mirror, I'm cool. I don't care what you see. I'm happy for who I am. As long as I'm happy for who I am, then it's going to rub off on people.
Now, I love that, man. You said two more powerful things. And, man, this is, I don't know, I wish I couldn't have wrote it this way. But I just appreciate the fact that you're saying about that no matter what, you have to do it for yourself.
Sure.
Like, your mentality has to be there.
Yeah,
because the truth about it is doing something for somebody else, it only lasts so long.
Yeah, you know? Exactly.
Because it's going to change.
Exactly.
But when you're doing it because that's for you and that's what you want to do, and so now I'm doing it for me, but me doing it for me benefits my family, my kids, my other. Now it really takes effect and it has longevity and what's going on. Man, so I appreciate that. I love that, man, and that's just why I appreciate you being open. Now, I got to move because T-Money giving me this look. He done left the room and everything, so I know what that means. When he leave out, that means you got about 5 minutes,
all right, before the
mics cut off and all right. That. You know? So, now, my question for you is, how did the Duck... See how he popped back up?
Right, coach. Your time limit's up.
Right. Okay. How did the idea of Douglas Lemonade form and then come into fruition?
All right, boom. What they say? All right, boom.
All right, boom.
Boom. All right. So we're gonna give the short story, a little bit drawn out, but not too long.
Okay.
You know, so we can get up out of here.
All right,
so I'll be honest. I was in Cargo Largo. I seen a
this is the Douglas Lemonade.
It's a Douglas thing. You better get it.
Yeah.
I was at Cargo Largo, seen a juice squeezer, and I'm in love with apple juice. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to start making my own apple juice. I'm tired of buying Martinelli's apple juice. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I said I was going to make my own apple juice. I tried a couple times. It failed. Then I was like, all right, orange juice. So the orange juice was cool. And I was like, you know what? Man, I'm going to try to perfect my grandma's lemonade. Like I told you before, yeah. My father was in a good space. Uh-huh. So I was like, Pops, I was like, you remember how grandma made her lemonade? He was like, nope. So I'm like, all right. So the little bits that I remembered as a kid, I started whipping it together. So I just did a little different things when it came to my recipe. And I added, and I just kept adding. I kind of was like a mad scientist in the kitchen. And any of my partners that would come by, I'd be like, taste this, you know. Next thing I know, they like, bro, you got something. Like, literally. So by this point, I wasn't even bottling up. I was emptying out water gallon jugs.
I love it.
And I was filling up the jugs and just selling it by the jugs, right? And they like, bro, you need to bottle this up. You need to sell it. So that's what happened. I started bottling it up. I went back to my era. I said I'm an 80s baby, but I was raised in the 90s.
Yeah. I got you.
It's a hustle. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I went for. I took it to a hustle. So me fresh out, I was going to pop-ups. I was just doing pop-ups. Anybody that was doing pop-ups, Black Wall Street, any pop-ups.
I'm stopping you.
Yeah.
You know, I caught that.
What?
You said me fresh out.
What you mean?
That's what you said. You said me fresh out.
Yeah.
I'm going to pop-ups.
Yeah. Fresh out. I started connecting with pop-ups. Like, yeah. I had a table.
You talking about fresh out the store? Of the lemonade?
Of my lemonade.
Okay, well, you know, I'm from the hood, too. Fresh out means you came from a place.
No. Okay, I didn't come from a vacation.
I'm just asking. Yeah, vacation.
Yeah, I ain't got no S on my report card.
Okay, I'm just asking.
I ain't got no S on the report card.
I'm just saying. I had to put that out.
So I jumped fresh off the porch when people around me told me that I had something. They not going to lie to me. They keep it 100. I keep it 100 with them. They keep it 100 with me. So. As soon as they said it, I just invested in myself.
Gotcha.
I bought me like 150 bottles. I started doing pop-ups. First pop-up I was doing, I would have a big jug, one of them orange 5 gallon.
You know what I'm saying?
And so I was giving samples. So as people walk by, I get samples. You gotta. What people don't understand when it comes to business, you can't just go into business and
that's
think
some
it's just
tasters.
Gonna go. Yeah, you gotta spend money to make
you got
money.
To.
So in the first beginning, you gonna lose because you're trying to get
it
your
ain't losing.
It's losing in the beginning, but you're gonna
it's
get it on losing. The you're gonna get it on the back end.
It's called advertising.
For sure. For sure. So you're right. So I was advertising. So I was getting it out there. So as people, you know, was tasting it, they come back. As soon as they down that cup, they was coming back. Let me get two bottles. So then once the pop-ups was popping, now let's go to these stores. Stores don't even know who I am, but I don't care.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So got to the stores. Some of the stores owners was like, my very first person that started messing with me was Matt, was Turkey Leg Man.
Turkey Leg Man.
He got a new spot on Quindera.
We know that.
He be moving around. So he was the first person that really got me on his truck. And he actually is one of the top sellers of the lemonade.
Yeah.
So once he started booming, I'm like, let me get it to these stores. So I got to these stores, and some of the store owners was like, I don't know what this is. So what I do is I'll leave you a regular, I'll leave you a strawberry, taste it, give you my card, and I'll go back and holler at them in a couple days. Well, while I did that, people that was my friends that was buying it from the house, I sent them to the stores to tell them, where's the Douglas lemonade?
It's all in
advertising. You have to advertise yourself. You got to get yourself out there. Anybody trying to start your own business, if you're not advertising yourself and you don't think your product is the best product out there, who else going to believe it? So that's the mentality I went into. So if you told me no, I'm going to stand outside in the store and I'm going to sell my lemonade. And that's what I did. I had a cooler in the trunk. You know what I'm saying? Everybody walk in. Hey, I got some Douglas lemonade. It wasn't nothing like this. It was a sticker. When you dumped it in water, the sticker would
peel off.
It was terrible.
Yeah.
But I knew I had a product.
Yeah, the product.
So the label didn't matter. It's my product that's mattered. But once I can get the eye visual of my product, people walk in the store, this is gonna catch your eye now. But that's just things you learn in business as you go on. Nobody taught me this. This is things I learned,
and I just paid attention to it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's why kids pay attention in school. You have to pay attention to things. If you don't pay attention, you're never going to learn what you need to do next. So as I got in one store, the first store I got into was off James A. Reed and Bannister. That's okay. The first, that is called Snap and Go.
I know exactly what you're talking about. My people say okay.
Yeah, so that's the first store I got it in.
Okay.
So I always hit my stores with testers, only maybe 10 of each, just for that first little go to see how it goes. But I already got a nice fan base to where people gonna pull up. Out South is my area, so anybody that knows me out South is gonna go to that store. So I locked that down first.
Okay.
And then from there, it just started booming. That store just started doing numbers. Like, that store is up to 80 bottles a week, if not more.
Man,
you know what I'm saying? So once I locked down that store, he was like, this lemonade doing so good, I got another store on 39th.
Yeah.
He was like, I want to get you in there.
Man, okay.
So I got in there. So once I got in there, he, same thing. So now I'm moving from store to store. Now people's literally going in asking for places. It's people going Jack Stack and ask, you got some Douglas lemonade?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, it's people that go to Chicken Go. They say, do you got some Douglas lemonade? I got videos of it. Yeah. They literally go in there and ask for that Douglas lemonade. That's what I need, because when I go to these stores, they're going to automatically know who I am because the fan base is already running.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's literally, I just grind it. I grind. I perfected my craft. I grind it. You know what I'm saying? Nothing comes easy. You're gonna fail, and what I mean by fail, not in the advertising, you're gonna fail sometimes because everything is not gonna be a success.
It's offhand. Trial and error.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. But long as you stay dedicated and you know what you got, you good.
You know, I love that, man. I love being able to explain the journey and how it goes, but also explain the hustle. Because a lot of times what people, especially our youth, don't understand is that it took work to get there. Yeah. It just didn't happen overnight.
Yeah.
I mean, you had to figure out the recipe.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You had to taste it, test it. People had to tell you, man, you got something. Then not only you had to do that, you had to start selling it so people could start building a brand, a name, to get it out there, you know? Mm-hmm. Then you had to start packaging it right and understand the packaging.
Yeah.
You know?
All that.
Then you got to get into store. Like, it's just, it's more to it than just saying, you know, I own a business or I do something. It's a lot. So I appreciate that. Couple more questions, because, you know, when he started crossing his legs.
Legs mean business.
That mean business. That means just open.
Watch out.
You know what I'm saying? Watch out. So let me hit you with this.
Yeah.
What is the advice that you would give any of our listeners, but especially our young listeners, or any listeners, you know, about chasing a dream, starting a business, being a producer, you know, because one of the things that we push is, man, we as a community have to become more producers than consumers, you know. And what I mean by that is, yeah, I'm going to support your business, but we all need to be producing the products that we all consume.
Right.
And when we do that, we build. If I have, Dave got water, you got lemonade, my guy got Sleek Vodka, my guy got, you know what I'm saying, Confidence 71, we got, you know, Brainiac 91, you know, Truth Apparel, like we have all the different things. If we all are producers and we all are spending the money in what we are producing, it comes back to us.
Yeah.
So what advice would you give?
For real, pay attention to school. That's number one. And the only reason why I'm saying that is because there's things that I didn't think I was going to need when I got out of school. You know, as kids, we go in school, we be like, man, I don't need to learn this. I ain't going to use it. Algebra? For what? But you use it. I use it when I make my lemonade. Never thought that I got to know my measurements.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I didn't think I was going to.
Me, off tops, I'm just number wise. So I'm good at numbers. But if I wouldn't have paid attention in school when it came to algebra and mathematics and knowing a cup and a half equals this, or, you know, add this to this,
I wouldn't be able to do this. I know how to break this down any way possible. That's because I know the numbers and I paid attention in school, and I know addition, subtraction, multiplication. You know, I know how to read. Yeah, I know how to read. I know how to write. I know how to speak. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's, you know.
Now, I don't mean to interrupt, but you say, and I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. I hate to ever interrupt, but you just said something that hits me. You said, I know how to read and I know how to speak.
Right.
So you say you know how to speak because you have to speak to do what?
Communicate, to talk.
Right, but I'm talking about to sell my product. To sell the product. Sure. Right, correct. Right. Okay. I can't just
go to people like, hey, man, you know what I'm saying? Like, hey, you just want to buy this stuff or you going to what you going to do?
There you go. Okay.
I can't do that. You got to know how to get up to people to make a person feel comfortable to even try your product.
Man.
You know, you can't go up to a person just looking crazy and think a person going to buy your product. You got to be approachable. And that's one thing my grandma, my mama started me on. It don't matter. It don't matter what I got in my pocket. You'll never know. Because you know why? Because I'm going to always be presentable.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to always be willing. You're going to always want to talk to me because I'm just that type of person. But
man, I pray because that's something we preach. Like, you know, we have communication cards. We tell you, I learn how to have conversations.
Yeah, for sure.
Introduce.
Got to have dialogue.
Elevator speeches. Like, you got to be able to talk to people because you never know what job, what you're selling, what you're doing, and you just can't talk to people any kind of way. You just can't walk up to a person and think they're going to buy something for you because you say, man, buy this.
Nah.
I don't get it. Okay. Right. No, I appreciate that. I know we got to go. You know, I see him over there. Okay. So, two more questions.
You
got anything?
No, man.
Okay. Yeah, I see you looking at T. Your hands is built like, oh, you better hurry up. Okay.
Hey, I don't want T to come over and swing.
Because T will be coming. You know, the mic, I can tell the mic is getting close. All right.
Stay ready.
Two more things.
Yep.
And I'm going to get, we behind. T about to get us. He about to get us. All right. So, I'm just saying, I know what he's saying. You know, T money. You know, y'all understand. You know, T money quiet. He don't say nothing. But when all y'all leave, he gonna come hit me and say.
First of all, he let his shirt do the talking.
Go.
I mean,
he gonna hit me, y'all. He gonna hit me with it when y'all leave. He don't say nothing in front of nobody. But when y'all leave, he gonna let me have it. He gonna say, man, you ain't see my cues. Now you told me I was third in command, and I'm just sitting and I'm like, okay, T, my bad. All right, I apologize. Let me run. All right, that's my guy, T-Money. If y'all don't know about T-Money, let me give you something. You know, I love T-Money. We appreciate him around.
Yeah, we love T-Money.
T-Money is one of our interns from the summer program.
Okay.
We're the summer program, and we had interns doing this right here, our TV and radio broadcast,
gotcha.
Digital media program. And from here, T-Money has stuck with it and moved. You know, so now T Money is now one of our paid interns.
Okay.
He's also doing things. He's moving up as far as now he's doing things with producer credits, you know what I'm saying, editing credits.
That's dope. That's
you
dope.
Know what I'm saying? Production management credits for our television network. Like, he's just doing things.
That's dope.
And he applied for Northwestern University.
Let's go,
okay.
T-Money.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
My man. So, T-Money, we love him. We appreciate him. We go there. So, that's why we always talk about him, man. He hustling. He getting to it. He go. Now, people don't know this about T-Money. Put this last thing out there. And I don't say much.
Yeah.
But T-Money also, you know, did a photo shoot for our sleek vodka tasting. At the I'm KC store.
On 18?
Yeah, on 18. Yeah, he did the photo shoot for that and all that.
Okay.
And then T-Money this week was the Ego Student of the Week Award winner.
So dope.
He was the Ego Student of the Week Award winner in the Dispatch Post USA.
Yeah, that's dope. Yeah. That's dope. That's dope. That's dope. That's dope. That's dope, though. Yeah, that's dope. Yeah, okay.
I had to spend a little time just saying a little bit about him. You know, appreciate
him. Hey, T-Money coming on my credits real soon, commercial or something. You know what I'm saying? We got you, T-Money. I already got the idea and everything for
it.
We're going to get it. We're going to get it.
So, two more questions and we out of here.
Yeah.
One question, second to last question. Who would you attribute influence to? Like influence to helping you be who you are to a person. You know, one thing I always say is we always have people that we try to emulate, we look up to, or we like, man, this person, whatever. Sometimes good and bad. Right. I mean, it happens.
Right.
But who would you attribute influence to you, you know what I'm saying, pushing this Douglas Lemonade?
So it's going to kind of sound like, you know, like the political correct question, I mean, answer. Mm-hmm. But I'm be honest, my mama and my sister.
Okay.
Yeah. Those was the two most important people that stood behind me and let me know what it was. My mom, she has a nonprofit business. I seen her hustle from leaving the corporate world to starting her own nonprofit business for women in Arizona. She ran it for 8 years. She ended up closing the doors, but now she travels around the United States helping other people start business and talking. So I just seen her hustle, her grind. I always tell my sister, like, I got the hustler side of mama. You got the job typing side of mama. You know what I'm saying? I'm more out in the field. I like to be with people. I like to talk. I like to mingle. My sister, she's more laid back, you know, computer supervisor, manager at her job. You know what I'm saying? That's just the lane she chose. But me, I'm just more of the people's person and the go-getter. And it's really from my mama. Like, me literally seeing my mama raise two kids and grind. At times she didn't know where things was gonna come from, but she found a way. You know what I'm saying? So I can't do nothing but respect that. You know what I'm saying? So my mom is that biggest influencer, period. And then my grandma Douglas is what helped me just start that Douglas Lemonade, because she was that strong black woman.
Say the name again.
Douglas Lemonade. It's a Douglas thing.
Okay, all
you
know, right.
Douglas over everything. I keep it going.
Yeah, I
you
didn't
try
I
the rest, now come get the best.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
We can keep this going. I love it. Okay, so now T Money, you know, this one, he know we're at the end, because you see how he, you know, they telling me, like, yo, it's time. Okay, T Money going to get behind this camera. He going to tell you where to look.
Okay.
Our question is this. If you had the attention of the world, 20 seconds. Now, I understand what I said, Craig. Attention of the world, Craig. Attention of the world, Craig. Yeah, attention of the world for 20 seconds. And don't slap your mama. All right, with this barbecue. But attention of the world for 20 seconds. What would you say? Now, don't tell us what you would say. Mm. I was trying to get you some extra seconds.
Right, keep talking.
Because
yeah,
T-Money going to count you down. He going to tell you what camera look at, and you're going to look in that camera, and you're going to give us exactly what you said. Because we walking you down to the camera, you got to give it. Boom. 20 seconds, attention of the world. What would you say? T-Money on the countdown. What camera you at, Money?
Let's go.
This one here? Give him the countdown.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Come out, get this Douglas Lemonade. It's a Douglas thing. I want y'all to know that first, keep God first in your life. Keep your grind tight. Hustle hard. And no matter what nobody says, believe in yourself and you can do whatever you imagine. It's a Douglas thing. Keep it popping.
Okay, hold on. That was okay.
That was all right. I need to go
again. That was all right. But I'm going to just say this, you know. I'm listening in. There's people in this world
right.
over in China. And I'm sitting here and I'm listening. I'm like, you know, well, how do I get this stuff listening?
Okay.
I don't even know how to get this.
You're right.
I can. So he said, come get it. And then told me right then, but I didn't tell you nothing. Get to Douglas Lemonade or
let me
nothing.
Let pull this up real quick so I can give y'all all my locations.
So now he want to get on his phone.
Yeah. Nah, I just got to get the locations because I want to make sure y'all have the address.
Well, I'm in China.
You in China?
This is the attention of the world.
Of the world?
Craig.
Go to Teaching of the World,
go to Douglas, Brent. Go to Douglas Lemonade, okay, LLC.
Hold on.
Okay.
All right. Teach
money. All
right.
Are
you going to let him do it over?
No, we're not going to let him do it over. But what we're going to let him do now so that we can put this on the show.
Right, right.
Is look in there and tell him where to find Douglas Lemonade.
All right. First, y'all can go to my website. Y'all can go to Douglas Lemonade, LLC. Y'all can definitely go on there, check out all my locations. But definitely, since we hitting China today,
I'm gonna let y'all know. We could definitely go to, hold on, give me a second. All right, so we got like five locations. We got 8201 East Bannister Road, Snap and Go. We got 5353 39th Street, that's also a Snap and Go. We got 3550 East Truman Road, Presto Liquor Store. We got 3510 East 27th Street,
KC Cajun. If y'all ain't had that Casey Cajun, I'm gonna tell y'all something. That's a good mix. Cajun food with Douglas Lemonade, can't go wrong. I'm telling you.
We got Turkey Leg Man. Y'all see him all around town. And he on Quindaro. He out in Kansas with my Kansas people.
I'm gonna tell you. Hey, Kansas really was popping with my lemonade for a very long time. Like, they was my first supporters, for real, for real. And then we got Taste of Love. And that's at 5220 Blue Ridge Road. Taste of Love. Another restaurant, for sure.
That's dope.
Okay. That's dope. There we go. You know, we're going to give him to add one more thing on there, you know, coming up. You know, we're going to give him to add Jenna Club. It's just,
We going to get it popping.
William, man, we appreciate you coming.
I appreciate y'all.
Bro, yeah. You know what I'm saying? One more time, y'all. Everybody here, let's give William his Oscar, please. Yo, next week we got coming here, same bad time, same bad channel right here, 1739. We have, you know, Kimology herself, Kim Newsom, coming. All right. And
so
then we got
music here.
By Slick. We got that coming next week. All right, right here. I got to say, man, we appreciate everybody for coming. You know what I'm saying? We love you.
We appreciate you.
So.
And we thank you for coming out.
Together,
we are
Culture Keepers.
So. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, thank you so much for being a part of Even Social Podcast. You know, bye.
I really want to appreciate y'all, though. I really want to appreciate y'all sitting on your couch, you know.
I heard you was nervous.
I hope you got over that. I ain't even gonna lie. This is my first time really doing like a podcast or really getting out there media wise. I did some hood little videos to promote myself, but really being in front of the camera where I'm getting exposure the way I'm getting exposure. This is the first time, and I definitely had them jitters, but y'all made it comfortable. Y'all family, you know what I'm saying? Y'all family now, so y'all definitely made it comfortable.
Well,
I'm definitely gonna come back.
We gonna talk about that lemonade, you know what I'm saying? Come on, hang out.
All right, let's go.
All right, man, we appreciate y'all. You know what I'm saying? Thank you much. We gotta say thank you. You know what I'm saying? To our DJ, Ben Rich. You know what I'm saying? Please go follow Ben Rich at DJ Ben Rich on IG. I'm telling you, I say this all the time. People don't understand why I say this. My DJ better than yours.
Ooh.
I'm saying any genre, anything
you need.
Say it
with your chest.
You want me to say it again?
Say it with your chest.
My DJ is better than yours. My DJ is better than yours. My DJ. I'm just telling you. Anything that you can think of, any genre, anything you want to do, he got it. I'm talking about anything. He did a dog party. Mm-hmm. Had the dogs barking and running. It's all, I mean, you think I'm lying? I'm just saying. He got anything from weddings to receptions,
bar
anything. Bar mitzvahs. He can
for
do
sure,
all that.
For sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
He got you. All right. Check him out. All right. We appreciate you. We love you, man. But do not forget, one of my favorite songs is coming up. You know what I'm saying? With my guy, Wizard Wop. You know what I'm saying? I begged him, and he gonna come out with that. Arrivederci. All right. Here we go. Appreciate you. All right. I am Coach Mo.
And I'm Jabril Janae.
And we out.
Yo, so this song right here, No Box, you gotta listen to the words. It has a lot of double meanings, but mostly it's about a time a guy saw me fake sneakers on the internet. So let's go. No Box.
I can't tell if you real, got on my top for these niggas.